Business continuity is the single most important factor in the development of a successful disaster recovery plan. This video outlines the reasons why disaster recovery planning is critical to both large and small businesses alike, and the process by which to ensure your plan covers the items necessary to achieve business continuity at the lowest possible cost. The top four reasons why disaster recovery planning is critical are 1. Natural disasters. According to Gartner research, more than 40% of businesses will never reopen after a major natural disaster. In fact, 93% of businesses that had data center outages for 10 days or more filed for bankruptcy within a year. With business continuity incidents occurring more frequently, the need for a comprehensive disaster recovery plan is more critical today than ever before. 2. Hardware failures. Hardware failures account for 42% of all data loss. The loss of data can result in disruption of services, lost productivity and sales, and customer dissatisfaction, with potential damage to your brand and reputation. 3. Human error. According to research by IT security company DataBricks, human error is the biggest cause of data loss and data corruption, accounting for 70% of all data loss and failure in small businesses. Humans are fallible, and errors are to be expected. Therefore, a mitigation plan to ensure minimal disruption to business operations is absolutely critical to achieving business continuity. 4. Cybercrimes, ransomware and viruses. According to Fortinet, every minute, about 500,000 attack attempts are happening in cyberspace. The most effective preventative measure you can have is a disaster recovery plan. We recently published a video outlining the benefits of cloud storage using Amazon Simple Storage Service, or S3. If you've not seen that video, click on the link here to view it now. While an effective cloud storage solution is an essential part of any disaster recovery plan, data storage and recovery simply address a single aspect of a comprehensive business continuity plan. There are two metrics that should be used to dictate your overall disaster recovery strategy. 1. Recovery time objective, RTO, or the targeted duration of time within which a business process must be restored following a disaster or disruption. And 2. Recovery point objective, RPO, or the window of time in which data loss is acceptable. Armed with your recovery time and point objectives, you're now prepared to review the four disaster recovery solutions that Amazon provides for organizations of all sizes and budgets. Backup and restore. This is the most basic and lowest cost option, where you can back up data to Amazon S3 or Amazon Glacier and restore it using AWS import or export. With backup and restore, you also have the option of taking snapshots of Amazon EBS volumes, Amazon RDS databases, and Amazon Redshift data warehouses. Pilot Lite. The Pilot Lite option consists of a minimal version of your environment's most critical elements running in the cloud. If things go down, you maintain your business critical element. The Warm Standby solution provides a scaled-down version of your fully functional environment, always running in the cloud. This is essentially a more robust form of the Pilot Lite option because more elements are always active. Lastly, the multi-site solution runs an active-active configuration in both AWS and your existing on-premises infrastructure. If your on-site resources go down, you can adjust your DNS, or, using a failover policy within Amazon Route 53, automatically reroute traffic to AWS with minimal downtime. Creating a successful disaster recovery plan takes work. With the expertise that can help you choose the right plan, we can provide the guidance you'll need to best set up your disaster recovery solution in AWS for success.